following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for
that's awesome.
For a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Create the perfect relationship between you and your body. Treat your body with love, honor, gratitude, and respect. When you make it a goal to adore your body and accept yourself completely, you'll learn to have a perfect relationship with anyone else you are with. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 30, NASDAQ up 8, S&P's flat, gold contract down $2.40, trading at $12.27 an ounce, silver up 7 cents, $15.45 an ounce, copper flat, $2.75 a pound. Light sweet crude, that's where the beating's taken in and out here, folks. You get light sweet crude down $2.34. We're trading out there at $66.83. Notes and bonds, you get them both up one tick. 10-year note, up one tick, trading at 119.16. 30-year bond, up one tick, 142.20. King dollar down 141 ticks, trading 94.904. The euro is trading at a price point of 116 to one U.S. dollar. The yen is out here at a price point of 110.99 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of oil, gas, all of the above, folks, they are taking a beating out here. So check it out. You get gasoline down 3.8% or 8 pennies, trading at $2.02 wholesale a gallon. We have crude oil down 3.3%, $2.32. Big numbers. You get diesel down 2.3% off 5 pennies. So you get big numbers out here. If we go into the crude market first, we take a look at the crude market. What you have out here with crude, you're down with 709,000 contracts, monster contract volume. You're going against a swing point. You're breaking that swing. The swing you're breaking is $66.29 from the 18th. So what you have here is a small ABC down. Your A point is 72.80. Your B out here is 66. So we're talking about, that's actually $6. Pretty cool. Which gets you down to 64. And 60 is pretty wild. 62 is actually a lower swing point. The lowest swing point we're talking about is from the 18th of June. I do expect we're going to make our way down into that level. This thing no doubt came down fast and furious starting at 6 o'clock this morning. And what you have there is, you bottom line is that you're talking about tariffs on fuel products going into China. It's a big number too, folks, okay? In the next segment, I'll get into the amount of different products that are gonna get a 25% tax, but there are multiple products, big numbers. Some of the high volume stock out here, let's go to Tesla first. So Tesla yesterday, bottom line, Elon Musk does a tweet, 12.43 sends the stock higher. Right now, Tesla's trading down $5.82. You're at 3.73. Bottom line, you know, the board came out with a statement saying that, yeah, Musk had brought this up a couple times last week. They met three separate times about going bringing this private. That being said, folks, okay, what you are going to get out here, I suspect, and we'll see. We'll see if Musk so far has been like the Teflon Don, okay? Nothing seems to affect the equity nor the amount of money that he can raise when he's still in a huge losing position. We'll see how the SEC is going to deal with the aspect that, number one, is the tweet, was it material? There's a few ex-commissioners out here today of the SEC, bottom line, saying that they don't think anything was material inside of that tweet. And if that's the case, and what material specifically would mean is this. Material would mean that when he tweeted that out, that your probability was pretty good that, in fact, this is going to happen. You know, if this was just a deal that he wanted to pump up the stock, that's trouble in paradise. That's the real bottom line. So we'll see how that goes. The SEC, what the SEC had done approximately last April, I believe, there was a case that was the case that they had been looking at, and they come out and they said flat out that public companies absolutely can use social media in order to basically tell everyone simultaneously at the same time what is going on. That was a different case. That was saying flat out, okay, this is going on, I'm making money, I'm losing money, whatever you want to do. In this particular case, saying that we're going to go public, we want to bring the thing private at a certain price, that's a different ballgame, particularly if it hadn't, which it hadn't been voted on, it's been talked about. Different ballgame. Anyway, you get the gist of it. We go take a look at the XLE. You get oil going south. XLE out here, sideways move, down 63 cents. You do have a small expansion of volume. We're going at the 7.6 million. Right now you're doing 7 million. They'll more than likely throw another million shares into the close. We go take a look at ExxonMobil, XOM. ExxonMobil also going sideways, down 62 cents, trading $80.65. Chevron's CVX. Those are the two largest weighting structures inside the XLE. Chevron is down 159. Now, Chevron's got some movement. Down 159, you're going into a lower swing point of a 123.33. And we'll see whether they get any juice. I don't expect it to hit that today, but I do expect you're going to come into that tomorrow. The XLF, we go take a look at the XLF, the financials. Financials right out here, up 11 cents. You're 28.51. Now, that's still going in the top of the range with dramatically lighter volume. We are slamming into 85 million shares. That's when the XLF broke down on the 22nd of March. That's when the XLF had gone from a price point of $29.10. 3 days later, it was down to $26.77. So that's the supply line that you are going into, and it's having a tough time coming, getting through that supply line. Some of the other higher volume equities out here, Snap is down 72 cents. That came out with numbers last night. It was trading up $1.25 last night after the close. Down all day today, down 73 cents. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow's down 12, Nasdaq's up 13, S&P's are up 1.5. Coming right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks!
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 18. You get the Nasdaq up 13. S&P's flat. We take a look at this, some of the higher volume equities out here. Let's see what we have. So you get Bank of America up 40 cents. Facebook is up $2. Caesars Entertainment up 22 cents. The gambling stocks have been getting whacked big time. So that's a counter trend bounce. Marbell is down 4 cents. You get Intel up 25. Micron Tech up 32. Match Group, that's up $7. That got some juice underneath it. Now, they came out with numbers, and their Tinder part of it is growing. Revenue-wise, it's big revenue numbers, no doubt about that. This is going into a downdraft, the downdraft that had been created out here on the 5th, on the 1st of May. 1st of May, the stock went from 47 to 35 when it came out that Facebook is trying to put something together, and that, you know, that would basically compete with Match. Now, when we take a look at this in a much larger basis, what you're going to see is that this has been quite a run for Match. You know, Match in 2016 was $8.41. You're at $46 right now. You look at these revenues, and these are big revenues. 5 years ago, 2014, 4 years ago, they're doing $880 million this year. They're doing, so picture this. This is pretty amazing, actually. The whole year, 2014, they did $880 million. This quarter, they did $421 million. So bottom line, you can see they are in a business that is growing. We'll see if, in fact, they can get through that downdraft and if they can deal with Facebook. The GDX, let's take a look at the GDX. So the GDX out here hit a low today, $20.59. We're at 20.73 right now. We bring this back and we take a look at it. What you're looking at is this. The magic number. Well, no such thing as a magic number, I guess. But bottom line is that a number that you wanted inside of to get to higher price is $20.83. We hit $20.80 right now today. We've tested the lows with dramatically lighter volume. So this is a nice setup. The real key is that what we haven't got is follow through and signs of strength. What we're going to need here, after this test, is a sign of strength. The last monster sign of strength that we got goes all the way back to 2016. You know, it's pretty intense. You know, we had hit a low there of $18.58. We came off that low at a nice sign of strength, and that was a sweet run. We went from $18.50 straight up to $25. That run started in December and ended in February. You know, so bottom line is that we'll see how this baby shakes out. If we take a look at the XAU, the HUI, same type of setups. The XAU came down to a $73.82. Right now, we're out here trading at $74.42, and that has to get inside the 75.5 number. The Gold Bugs Index. We take a look at the Gold Bugs Index. Gold Bugs Index right now is trading 160.67. It got down to 159.39. And this one here, this has a long way to go to get inside the larger range. 170 would be the number, $10. Because what the Gold Bugs Index has done is this. The Gold Bugs Index actually went right down to the lows of December 2016. Now, same setup, meaning dramatically lighter volume, you know, down at those numbers, but bottom line is that you got to those numbers. So that, well, if we go over and we take a look at the US dollar, it's all hinges where the physical metal is gonna go on this dollar. What the dollar did out here today is that it failed on price, comes down, got a small expansion of volume. We'll see what we have any follow through. When you do look at this intraday, once again, every time this gets up to the 95 area, you have sellers in that US dollar, and they just seem to push them right in. What we had over here, if we go take a look at the the bond market, what you're going to see, the 30-year bond went down to 142.11, rejected lower price, had lighter volume. This is building cause. This is building cause to basically get up into this higher swing point again. The swing point we're talking about is 145.28. Let me see if I can get this for you. Yeah, they had some. So check this out. Okay, investors scooped up a record $26 billion today in 10-year treasuries, showing that the swelling U.S. government issuance has yet to put pressure on the long-term borrowing cost. The sale of the 2028 notes was $1 billion larger than the Treasury's May offering, which had matched the previous record set in 2009. Let's see, we want to know, oh, here it is. Here's the gauge of interest. So what you have here is this. So picture this, folks. Notes and bonds, we talk about every day. The reason that that market is so important, of course, is that everything's tied to the 10-year note, meaning your credit cards are tied to the 10-year note. The mortgage rate is tied to the 10-year note. The Federal Reserve has gone up on short-term bank-to-bank rates. That's what they control. You know, so right now, the short-term, let's see, where am I, WB? Yeah, there we go. So right now, your 10-year yield is 1 second. So right now, the effective rate from bank to bank, which the Fed controls, the discount rate, is 1.75 to 2. The probability that we go up, or the Federal Reserve goes up on the 26th of September, right now is laying out there at a 92% probability. So the way it's set up, the Fed's going to go up again. It's going to go up to 2 to 2.25. Now, when you have that spread that's like that, most times what you see, if I bring this over, what you're going to see is that you're going to see an effective rate on the top of this Bloomberg. That effective rate right now, that's what they were lending money for last night, which is 1.91. So it's a sliding scale. It's always a sliding scale of 25 basis points. Now, what we have after the, let's say we get the rate hike that comes in September. So now you get a short-term rate that's running 2.25, and we got a 10-year, what you're gonna see is at 2.9. So the higher that the Fed goes on the discount rate, they're trying to push the 10-year. What has happened out here on a continual basis is because there are so many buyers for the 10-year, they're having a hard time pushing that over 3%. You know, what you had out here today, so check this out. This is how many folks, for every dollar that was pushed out in debt, the sale drew $2.96. That's a huge number, folks, okay? That is saying that the investor appetite for the 10 years is huge, okay? That's how it shakes out. So, and you can, that totally makes sense when you take a look at the aspect of how much higher our rates are than the rest of the world's. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow out here is down 9. NASDAQ is up 13. S&Ps are up 1. We go over to Michael Kors. We take a look at Michael Kors. Kors right now is trading up $4.10, $69.70. Let's see what they had to say. I believe they, okay, so here's the numbers on Kors. The first quarter earnings per share was $1.22. The full year, what they had seen is this. They had seen an estimate of $4.78. Now they're looking at $4.90 to $5. Bottom line is that let's see, they are pushing in some money. So if we take a look at this, revenue-wise, what you're going to see is they're still growing. Pretty amazing, actually. 4 years ago, they took in $3.3 billion. This year, they're banging out $4.7 billion. So big numbers. They're doing, they just did one point, actually, this year, they're already in their fiscal 2019 area, $1.2 billion. That's what they just did in 90 days. If we take a look at this equity, what you're going to see inside this equity, let's pull this back a bit. This is, you talk about a highly volatile equity. Holy cow. So this has been in a consolidation since February of this year. Oh, this is going to be pretty intense, actually. So this is what you have. Look at this. We have a high that was generated in February of $69. We went from 69 to 56. We tested the 69 in April. It failed, so we went from 69 down to 57. This is going to be crucial this week, folks, and this is what it is. 28 million shares. Oh, this is pretty cool. So check this out. So you get a high-end, high-volume consolidation. Now, watch this. This is subtle. This is pretty wild. If we take the tops of these and the bottoms of these, what you're going to see is that, and this is where the market talks, walks, and squawks. And what it is this. So your first bar from February, right? $69.95, 28 million. Your next bar, 13 million, meaning when it tested it. Well, we get the test going on again. Now, you get two more days of trading. We're at 13.5 million. Let's just kind of, we can gauge this. It was huge volume today because they came up with the numbers last night. So thus far, the number we got to keep our eye on again is 28. We're at 13. There's no way it's going to do 28. Okay, so this is how that shakes out. If this fails on price, I don't see us getting that kind of volume in two more days because we have 7 million today. We did 6.4 million the prior 2 days. If we just take it all and we, you know, say, okay, you get 13, let's add another, 14 in there, you're still at 27. And add another 14 in there, would be saying it's going to do 7 million both days. So anyway, the number to keep your eye on here is going to be $69.95 because it got over that number. If it can't close over that number, bottom line, what you have is that you have the high volume low that's laying out here from October 1st, the high volume low that's laying out there from the February 9th area. So this is going to be pretty cool watching how this shakes out. Let me put this back further. Yeah, when you put this on a monthly too, what you have is this. This is pretty amazing. Michael Kors had hit $101 in 2014. You're coming into a decent supply line. That supply line started in August of 2013, went all the way over to March of 2015. But bottom line is that they're making money. That is the bottom line. Fundamentally, they're making money. Technically, it's going to be important that they can get up and over that level. Bitcoin, you talk about some volatility. We've got volatility in Bitcoin. And folks, if you haven't test-driven yet the Nadex platform, it's a great time to do it. Bottom line, defined risk. You can check out the Bitcoin on the weekly basis, on the monthly basis. Take a demonstration account, understand how these defined contracts work. Just go to TFNN.com. You'll see the banner on the top of the side. Now, you talk about a trip up and a trip down. So picture this. If we go back to July 13th, Bitcoin's at 6,081. Took off 8 days later, you're at 8,400. 10 days later, you're back to 6,012. Now, the cool thing here is that we definitely had strength, you know, on the 16th, which the low there is 6,330. It come down. This would be a test. Now, we don't have volumes on Bitcoin, but this would be a classic test. This was the first time it was a big bounce. So we'll see if Bitcoin can get any juice and get out of this area. What we definitely had out here today is the fast, furious one-way route on the way down. This started at about 12:30 yesterday. It was at 71.29, and bottom line, just get down to this 61. Yeah, it did. It went down. This thing went down $1,000 in 24 hours. Big, big number. So volatility, Bitcoin still has it in spades. Apple is still at that $1 trillion market cap. We're trading at 207.32. And it's just at it. That's what's pretty wild. We're just over it. I believe the number is 207. It's probably going to register. I think it's 207.45, actually. Now, bottom line is that it's still up at that number. Go take a look at Amazon. Amazon out here. Now, Amazon, I believe this, let's see. So your high volume high is 1880. You're 1888 right now. Amazon, I saw this number come across today. Yeah, here it is right here. So right now, Amazon, Americans last year bought $200 billion worth of stuff from Amazon and its Whole Food grocers. That figure is based on Bloomberg Intelligence estimates that Amazon sold $300 billion of merchandise in 2017. In the company's report that two-thirds of income came from the U.S. If that's accurate, Amazon captured 5% of the American retail spending, excluding cars and car parts and visits to restaurants and bars. It, what's so intriguing about that statement, folks, is this, is they want to be in the car parts business in a huge way, and I expect they're going to get in that business. They've been in that business, but I expect they're going to get a lot bigger in that business, because you can see I'm selling cars. I don't think they're going to get that. But the car part business, huge deal. Visits to restaurants and bars, I can't see how they're going to get in that business. But the car parts business, that is ripe, because what the car part business has a couple of different things that at first would seem that they wouldn't have a competitive edge, but they do. And what it is this, is that you have all these dealers across the world, United States, right? Fixing your car, getting the product in. Most of the time what you have is that whether it's auto parts, whether it's O'Reilly's, you have the calling up, they get delivery services, all that. Well, guess what? Amazon is what a logistics company. That's what it really comes down to. A logistics company that pushes the spreads down. Bottom line, you can expect they're going to be in that business also. Dow Industrials, Dow is down 12. NASDAQ is up 15. S&P's up 1.5. Come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Eddie Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked, money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 11. NASDAQ's up 15. S&P's are up 1.5. Bottom line is that you get a sideways market out here, folks. If we do look at the NDX 100, the move is inside the NDX 100, bringing the baby up as you have X-ray. That is a dentist supply. That got smoked yesterday. That's up 2.7. Percent today, our dollar, and that is just one dead cat bounce. You got to remember something. Yesterday, it went from a price point of $48 down to $40. So you can expect that some kind of dead cat, that, and that's what you got out there. Take-Two Interactive, that's up 2.6%. You get Lam Research up 2.2%. If we go back and we take a look at Take-Two Interactive, this has a little juice underneath it. So let's see what this is doing. We're talking about the video games out here. This is trading 125.43 right now. This is at highs, has volume behind the move. And this has been pushing into the highs of last week with volume. So bottom line is that this very well can break topside once again. Big number. That's the taking the NDX 100 up, bringing it down. Regeneron is down 4.5% or $17. You get NetEase off 2.2%. A 597, Tesla down 2.8, you get Amgen down 2.1. If we go over to Regeneron, take a look at Regeneron, trading 373, you're down $17. That's not bad. Okay, so what you have here, when I say not bad, this thing popped topside on August 2nd. It went from 367 to 401, and you're backing into it. Now watch this. This is going to be an ABC up, I believe. Okay, so yeah, this is a small ABC. Well, it's a big ABC up. Your A point on this is 281. Your B point is 374. That's a good ABC. You're talking about, what did I say down here? You get, 80. So that's, you get 20. You get almost $80. And that would set up 440. 440. That's a good number. This is going to be interesting watching how this thing shakes out. Let's go look at Amgen. That was Regeneron we just looked at. Amgen right now is down $4.29, trading 196. This baby here also is at highs. Let's see, 201.23. This is trying to test what this almost did. Now, this is not in the type of shape that this is actually in better shape than Regeneron because it is at highs, but this also looks like it's gonna back down. This has been a one-way trip, but it was $39 in 08. Right now you're at the 196. You're trying to get into this 201 area. Gonna be intriguing, watch that baby shake out. We go take a look at the Euro. So the Euro out here, folks, right now is trading up 15 ticks. You're at 116, and this, as the dollar has been laying at that 95 high for, you know, since all summer, June, July, what are we, it's 10 weeks, the euro is laying at the lows. So you got a little juice in the euro today. We'll see if it can get up into this area of the 118. That's a big number. the yen over in Japan. We take a look at the yen in Japan. What we have with the, let's see, the yen in Japan right now, this is pushing into its lowest swing point of 110.59. And bottom line, we don't have volume on the, on this contract. Hey, we'll see where it shakes out, because what do expect you're going to see out here tonight, when the Nikkei, well, when the Nikkei opens, we're going to get some action. It's going to try to test out the 110. Yeah, the 110.59. That's how that baby's shaking out. If we go look at the Nikkei, we take a look at the Nikkei as an index. Bottom line is that last night you got up to a price point of a 22.800 and basically gave it up, 22.605. And if you want to see, you know, markets that basically gave it up, got a slight bounce last night, you can go right to the Shanghai. Let me pull this up. Because what you're going to see inside the Shanghai, last night it was down 1.2%. The prior night it was up 2.3%. But this has been a one-way trip. We go back 6 months, you're at 33.35. We're at 27.44. We take a look at this, and this is down hard, fast. It looks like it wants to trade into this 2600 area. And if we break 2638, it's trouble in paradise. That's the bottom line. Great Panther, we take a look at Great Panther. Great Panther, bottom line, took a hit yesterday, that's for sure. No, hit today, too. Interesting. Okay, so Great Panther went down to a buck today. We're at $1.04 right now. Let's go take a look at this. This got to get back inside. Well, this is going to be interesting. This got to get back inside the 106 area pretty quickly. It is going into strength going back from the 15th of April. That 15th of April, that's 96 cents. Now, it's back into that area with light volume, but for higher price, you want to get back inside this 106. And let's see what they're saying. I believe they came out with numbers. So let's see what they had to say here. Well, that might be the wrong story. Yeah, that's the wrong. Well, it's the story, but I'm trying to get one that's quicker. Let's see. Nope. Okay, let's see. So, Great Panther did an update on the trial scope and bulk sampling program of one of its gold, silver, lead, zinc mines located in Peru. Okay, so this is a mine that was placed on care and maintenance in 2013, acquired by Great Panther in 2017. In 2017, the company released an updated mineral resource. The bulk sample program was initiated because of release of a preliminary economic assessment, as detailed in the news release. Okay, so they're saying that this will process 6,000 tons of material and is expected to be finished in the first quarter of 2019. Yeah, bottom line is that I can go through the rest of these numbers, but you want to see this thing get back inside this $1.06 area. The $1.06 area is a crucial area, because the longer that you stay outside this $1.06 area, the higher the probability is that you can get down to that 96 cent area. So we go look at Vista Gold, what you're going to see with Vista. Vista basically came downtown too. If we go back a couple weeks, go back to the 19th of July, that was down to 56 cents. You had 86,000 shares. You tested that with 86,000 shares. Then you went topside with 310,000. Bottom line, we bring this back and put this also inside a longer range deal. We're looking for this. We want to see this get back inside. Well, actually, it just did it. It's 60.25, and we're at 60.53. Yeah, so that's so it looks to me like Vista will now start making its way up to this 72 area. Right now you're at 60. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. You get a sideways market out here today. Dow's down 19, NASDAQ is up 14, S&P's a flat. Coming right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. So Tesla right now down $10. And, you know, we were talking about the SEC and we just started this program. And that's Wall Street Journal just reported. Bottom line is that the SEC is making inquiries into the tweets, specifically the tweet, folks, that I didn't see this tweet that he had the funding secured. So if this is there must be a tweet out there because that's what they're saying. Bottom line is that that's going to be pretty intense, you know, so we'll see where this shakes out. If the Teflon Don is going to be all right with this, there's specific statements that the Wall Street Journal is making right now is that they are looking into, number one, that tweet, and number two, looking into the aspect, were the rest of these statements truthful? So that's a whole different number than the aspect in the aspect of tweeting in general. You know, that's what we're talking about. That the SEC had decided last April that yes, public companies can tweet. That's for sure. That gets everyone at the same time. Bottom line, though, you have to basically be making sure that you are tweeting something that is truthful. And not as just promoting and pushing that equity around. What I can't picture is that they actually already had the funding of $50 billion to do a buyout at that particular case, at that particular price. We'll see. We'll see how this maybe shakes out. You know, the bulls and bears out here on Tesla are pretty intense. There's no doubt about it. You know, Tesla had gone up $100 in 8 days. And if you want, I heard a case today of an analyst. I thought I was hearing things. The case today of an analyst was saying that Tesla today is undervalued, should be worth $2,000, and they're saying 5 years should be worth $4,000 a share. You know, they're probably smoking something, and whatever it was, wasn't good, folks. Stay right there, folks. Going to be coming back with some numbers after the close. Dow Industrials down 25, Nasdaq's up 12, S&P's a flat, gold up $3, silver up 6 cents. Light sweet crude taking a hit today, down 230, folks, trading 66.87. Less expensive gasoline's coming up.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionics, oil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look, it's a beautiful thing. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We're going to take it by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy tomorrow. I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Do your best, but don't overdo. Always do your best, but don't overdo. When you overdo, you deplete your body and you go against yourself, and it will take longer to accomplish your goal. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 45, Nasdaq up 4, S&P's down 3.5. Bottom line, folks, you had a sideways market out here. Inside the NYSE, let's see what they put in at the close. We had $500 million right before the close. Get 674 inside the NYSE. Nasdaq Composite trading out like a couple billion equity, couple billion shares. Inside the NYSE, yeah, 2.061. Gold contract up $3.30, trading at 1221. If we get open, we take a look at that gold contract. What you're going to see out here is that we got down to a low today of 1218, 70. This is pretty cool, actually, because you know what you're testing, folks, is that we are testing 1218.50, I believe. No, 1212. So 12.12.50 was the low that was generated out here on the 3rd of August. We had 255,000 contracts out here today, so I believe it's going to be a test on lighter volume. That was going into 280. So 255 to 280, 255 is still a lot. Bottom line, did reject at this point. We'll see whether we can get any juice coming out of here. With the gold contract has not caught a bid for 6 months. Silver, we take a look at the silver market we have with silver. Silver was up 0.4%. You're trading at a price point of $15.43. Silver is kind of a nice setup. You know, we'll see where this baby shakes out inside the silver market, but not a bad setup. What we have with silver is this. Silver got down to a price point of 1529, closed out at 1544, did 56,000 contracts. That 56,000 contracts was coming into 73, so it rejected that level. Now, bottom line, you need to follow through. Notes and bonds. You had the note and bond market flat out here today. They're each up one tick, 119.16 on the 10-year. 142.22 on the 30. What you did have in the 10-year was pretty amazing. You had a monster auction out here today inside the 10-year. Very successful auction. For each dollar in debt that we were selling, bottom line, there was $2.93 going after that. And what we did out here today, this was a record. Because our debt structure is going up so dramatically. Bottom line is that the Treasury sold $26 billion in 10-year notes that will expire as of 2028. So big number. This was the biggest number that we've sold since 2009. So you can see we're talking about some real juice here. But what we're also talking about is real demand inside the note market, inside the bond market. And that's what we need, bottom line, in order to keep these rates low. That's what you have. If we do take a look at the 10-year right now, what you're going to see is that we're still hanging right at that 3%. We're at 2.964. That being said, when you look at the rest of the world, what you're going to see is that our rates are still very high. If you're in France, it's 0.7% on a 10-year. In Germany, it's 0.4%. In Sweden, 0.5%. Switzerland, folks, is still negative. If you want to basically give the Swiss government money, it's going to cost you money. How about that? So they have a negative interest rate in the 10-year. We go take a look at Greece, which we know is broke. Their 10-year is 3.9. You know, so bottom line is that you can look almost right across the whole rest of the world. Our structure is a high structure. That's one of the main reasons that you have more demand then still supply, on top of the, we've never pushed something this much out since for a long period of time. So bottom line, you can expect more volatility in this market. The real question is going to be in the 10-year is that, can it get any strength? What the 10-year has done is that the 10-year has come back to its May strength. It did it with light volume. We've been at the same place now for approximately 2 trading weeks. The 119.16 area. We'll see where it gets down to strength. The way this technically is set up is that it came back and tested, got a small sign of strength last Friday. We went from 119.07 up to 119.20. Bottom line, we'll see whether, you know, get an additional sign of strength. King dollar out here couldn't handle price again. Pretty cool watching how King dollar is shaking out. King dollar, bottom line, each and every time it's up to the 95 area, huge problems. Bottom line, what it did do today is that when it sold down and had some juice on the sell down. Oil was the big story out here today. Oil came down fast, furious. This is all about the tariffs. This is going to basically pound the processes of oil because what you did have is that China's putting a 25% tariff on oil products. What we had out here today is that this baby did monster volume on the way down. You did 722,000 contracts. You're going into a lower swing point. You have an expansion of volume going into that swing point. I expect you're going to see that thing get taken apart. Coming into the close, Dow Jones reported that Tesla, bottom line, which is down $9 today, the SEC is basically talking to them about the tweets that were done out there. Specifically, what they want to look at is the tweet that Musk was saying that the funding for the buyout is secure, number one, and then they're going to look at the rest of those tweets. This is a report, according to the Wall Street Journal, as to whether they were truthful. And bottom line, which inside the public market, the SEC had already said last April that, yes, you can use social media to send out information to your shareholders and to information to the world. What you can't do, folks, is send out lies. That's the bottom line. And, you know, the has the funding, doesn't have the funding. It was either on the table, wasn't on the table. That's where the SEC is going to go with this deal. And what hasn't been reported yet, and this is going to be in here. It's going to be, when I brought this up yesterday, we brought it up again, Tommy and I, this morning show. The tweet was at 12:43. Well, guess what? By 12:43, the equity had already moved. 20 minutes prior to that, the equity stopped moving. Moving at 10 past 12. Before the tweet even come out, it went to 371. So bottom line, that and the option market, I suspect we're going to hear a lot more about that. Stay right there, folks. Coming back with our man, Mr. Jim Prince.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials finished down 45. We had the NASDAQ up 4, S&P's down 4.5. Oil contract, that little baby got smoked out here today, down 239, trading at 66.78. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Jim Prince, as we do each and every Wednesday at the 20 past the second hour. Jim's got a great website, folks. It's gbmembers.com. Jim Prince, what's happening, brother? I'm doing great, man. So
good.
I have your charts, and let's take a look at it, because we're going to start, and we're going to be looking at that oil market, aren't we?
Yeah, boy, what a beating it took today, right?
It certainly did. So here, let me get this first chart up. Okay, so I got the first chart up in front of me inside this oil market. You know, this the TAF thing, man, it hit it, and it hit it quick, didn't it?
Yeah, it sure did. So, yeah, so that is my support zone I have marked off there in the green, that right into the lows today. And
yes.
It tagged that. And the next level I'm looking, you see where that I have that ellipse drawn?
Yes,
right,
I do. Yeah.
So as my momentum indicator, which is on the middle panel there, as it's continuing to show weakness here, I anticipate that is going to be filled in. In other words, the market's going to move down into that level.
Okay. Yeah. You know, so it's intriguing, the aspect, you know, I can see where you get the support. Overnight, once that support breaks, bottom line, and as you said, you expect it to move down to the blue, that's that lowest swing point. So more than likely, that's what we're going to go after, I guess, huh?
Yeah, that's correct, if we continue to see this weakness here. And the big tell, of course, will be to see a close below that green zone that I have marked off there on the chart.
Yeah, and it's right next to it right now.
Yeah, sure is.
Totally. So let's take a look. I believe, let me see, I get two oil charts. Oh, I see. Oh, talk to me about this one. Is this a correlation between the crude oil and the 10-year bond note?
No, this is actually we produce a bunch of seasonal charts. And so this one in particular is the 10-year for the cash market. It shows the historical tendency.
I see. Okay.
And the blue line there, that is primarily what I just wanted to chat about a little bit today. That shows the average price over the course of the year, with the year being down at the bottom from 1 through 12.
I see.
And you can see how it peaks there. It tends to peak in June. And we almost have almost a double top there on that chart with the blue line.
Okay.
And this year, we're just a little bit out of sync with that. We put in our high here. Here in July, our second high, so we're just a tad out of sync, but we could still have that follow through. So you can see that the tendency is definitely to move lower here through the rest of the year. And with this pattern that we see, the break of the triangle pattern on the daily chart today, you know, we're kind of heading that direction right now.
That's nice. Gasoline's going to be less expensive. Gasoline, you know, we talk oil, of course, you know, in the product line, the gasoline got toasted also, man, in a big way.
Boy, it sure did. The whole complex outside of Natty Gas, everything got hit pretty hard today.
Yeah, and folks, if you're just joining us, we had the gasoline down 4% here today, or 8.5 pennies. You had crude down 3.4%, basically diesel was down 2.5%, 5 pennies, big number. So let's go over and we'll take a look at the U.S. Canadian dollar. So talk to me here.
Yeah, so this is a chart we've talked about, and I thought it would be a good idea to bring it on here, and we could actually see what I've been talking about. So if we go over there to the ellipse, you can see that big red candle right above it.
Yes.
And we were talking about that a few weeks back on the show, and then you see we had a little bit of consolidation, and then the market actually moved down, and I call that a fill-in of that ellipse. So that's what I'm kind of talking about with crude oil.
I see. Yeah.
So price moved right to the moving average there, consolidated. And now with today's action, actually popped up into that the higher box there that I have. That's actually Fibonacci zones from the 382, the 5618 levels. And it tagged that 50% level almost on the dot inside that box. And then we finished red on the session. So again, looking for some more weakness in here, at least another move back down to test these lows. And I have another little zone marked off there, basically where all the wicks are on the chart.
Yeah, you know what's going to be intriguing here is that, you know, you think that the aspect of, I guess the differential is yeah, trying to put the tariffs on oil products. There's plenty of oil in Canada, but the bottom line is that they're not in a trade war with China right now.
That's right.
Yeah, you know, because we're at $1.30 Canadian to $1 U.S., right?
Yeah.
And I guess if we break that 129, that'd be kind of serious, I guess, right?
Yes, absolutely. We do have some more zones there to the left, support zones. And I really focus on wicks on the candles as well. So I tend to see price, you know, fill in those wicks or move through to fill in those wicks. And that would put us, I think, the nearby, if this support gives way, we're looking through to about the halfway point there between the two moving averages. That red line is an 89 SMA and the purple is the 200 SMA.
Okay. So that'll be intriguing because what we did have today is that... You know, this dollar index is having a tough time each and every time for the last 7 weeks. It got up to that 95 area. It just backs down. It's light today, but the bottom line is that 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, 6 times in the last 8 weeks it's trying to make it. And, you know, the direct correlation, folks, would be on the other side of this, what Jim's showing us with the Canadian dollar right now. But it's kind of intriguing, man, watching this thing check out.
It sure is.
So what else are we looking at on the agenda? Well, you know, it's amazing. I mean, of course, it's August 7th, right? Normally in the summer, you know, bottom line is that it's not as volatile. But these currencies have been moving quite a bit.
They have indeed. I really like to follow the pound currencies, the pound dollar, the pound yen.
Okay.
And here, if we take a look here at the, I didn't send over this chart, but the pound dollar. Oh. Boy, here, this week has been extremely weak for the pound.
Yeah, I can pull the pound up right now. Let me get this baby up here. We got yeah, and this is going to get intriguing too, because I guess, you know, we have the aspect of, you know, number one is Europe slowing down. Oh yeah, look at this thing's like smoked, huh? This has been a one-way trip. 143, April 17th. Now we're at 128. I guess it's time for us to all go to London and have a little trip.
Hey, that sounds good to me.
So okay, so cool. So now your correlation, the pair you like to look at, Jim, is what? Pound versus?
The pound versus the dollar.
Okay, awesome. So what are you looking at in this one here now?
Yeah, so I have support just down below here, about 128.08
okay.
or so. So I'm looking for a continuation here, probably another 70 to 80 pips lower.
Yeah. And this one here, now it's intriguing here, you know, if you're looking at any of those moving averages, it's broken down, it's broken every one of them. 50, 100, 200, right?
Yes, indeed it has.
That's serious business, man. Okay, this is pretty cool. Let's take a look at this. I'll tell you, man. Some of these currencies, it's very well. I guess the last low that must have been Brexit. Yeah, well, Brexit, we were down at what, 121? No, lower than that, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Let's see. Yeah, no, 121. That was a beating there, man. Oh my God, unreal.
Sure was.
Listen, folks, you can find Jim at GBmembers.com. Check it out. The greatest business on earth, where American learns to trade and the future begins. The beautiful thing. Thanks so much,
thanks,
brother. Look forward to speaking
thanks,
to you next
man.
Week.
You bet.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
TFNN has put together the finest programming lineup each trading day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected financial minds in the nation to educate traders and investors. On Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, we broadcast 8 hours a day, starting at 9 a.m., as Larry Pesavento kicks us off with Trade What You See. Tuesdays and Thursdays, we broadcast 11 hours. Get an early and healthy start to your day, as Nico and Paige bring you Living a Primal Lifestyle. Then catch Andy Hecht at 5 p.m. with the Commodities Hour, following the Tom O'Brien Show. Swim lessons from TD Ameritrade, Thinkorswim, is now at 11 a.m., followed by Basil Chapman at 12 noon. See the TFNN program lineup via the link on the front page of TFNN.com to get a complete overview of our TFNN shows and hosts, and keep TFNN's Tiger TV tuned in on your mobile device, PC, or Mac for the latest financial news and information throughout the broadcasting day. TFNN.com, educating investors. This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over and take a look at Yelp. Yelp, bottom line is that's the social networking review site. Low for the year is $36, high is $48. We closed today at $38. This baby right now is trading at $43, so you get some big numbers, a big pop on this equity. Let's take a look and see what they have to say. Okay, so second quarter revenue, the expectation was $232 million. They did $235 million. Earnings per share, now this is a big one. Oh, this is a big one. So the estimate was 1 penny. They made 12 pennies. Okay, so they took in some numbers. So what's intriguing about that, of course, is that you can see that the bottom line, or the top line rather, they didn't take in that much more revenue, but their bottom line is saying that got explosive. You know, you're talking about 12 cents instead of 1 penny. We take a look at this on a monthly basis. What you're going to see, your high out here is $101. That was traded in 2014. Right now, you're at 40. If I say 43, yeah, you're 43.75, and your last swing high is 48. At 43, hey, it looks like it's, you know, this is a basically a high-end consolidation. So it looks like it's going to try to make a run for that higher end. Let's go take a look at Roku. This is the, of course, the audio streaming, video streaming, home entertainment systems. The low is $15.75 for the year. The high is $58 for the year. This closed at $47.25. It's trading at $50.60 right now. So this is trading at the last swing high that was established out here a few weeks ago. Numbers on Roku, let's see what we have here. So the revenue estimate was $141 million. They made $156. Good, that's a good number. That's a big number. Earnings per share, that's a big number too, 15 cents. They beat by 15 cents. Let me get this number though. Okay, here we go. So net revenue for the third, that's third quarter, 1 second, for the year. Okay, so here's the second quarter. The average revenue per user they got on the second quarter was $16.60. Their net revenue, the range had been $139 million to $145. They came in with $156, so they came out with a big number there. For the year, their range right now is the estimate was $691 million to $706. They have a new estimate. That estimate is going up to $710 to $730. So that's also a big number. That's a big number going right across all those scales. We take this, we put this back. Yeah, all-time high is $58. Right now, we are trading at $50. So bottom line, get some action into it. Jack in the Box. Let's go take a look at Jack in the Box. Jack in the Box closed at a price point of $85.85. The low for the year is 79. The high is 108. This closed at 85.85 today. It's trading 92.48. That's a big number. You're talking of up $7. This is coming into a downdraft from May. May it went from $91 down to 83 in 2 days. We are going to go 92. So you're up $7. Your last swing here, the lower swing, is 88. Now this is going to go for the highs. This is going to go for the top of the consolidation is 92. So let's see what they say number wise. This is where we go with Jack in the Box. It's so wild. I haven't been in a Jack in the Box since I was in the Marines in like 1970, 1969. Crazy. So Jack in the Box, and that was in Laguna Beach. Pretty wild. So let's see what we got here. Jack in the Box, same store sales, up 0.5%. That was the estimate. So that's not what's pushing the stock higher. Here we go. Okay. So the estimate was 88 cents. They took in a buck. Big number. Big number, man. Holy cow. Big number. No doubt about it. Take a look at the full revenue numbers here. So this equities, they must have spun something off or something, because if I bring this back 4 years, they took in $1.5 billion. Now they're only taking in $865 million. I don't know. This is, you know, what's intriguing about this, folks, is that the number, the wholesale number, the revenue number is going down, but yet the earnings number is going up. You know, the way that they have these numbers situated is this. In 2018, they plan on taking and $865 million for the year. Their earnings for the year is $3.81. Now, next year, they plan on taking in $768 million, but yet their earnings jump almost 90 cents to $4.69. So more than likely what you have happening here, and I think I know what it is here, they are going, they have restaurant sales as well as franchise restaurant sales. And more than likely what we're seeing here, I can see it in the numbers here. So the restaurant sale portion of it is growing very slowly. It's growing just about 1% over a 3-year basis. The franchise restaurant sales is growing by 3.3% over a 3-year basis. So you can see what's happening is that they can allow the total revenue to go down if the franchise restaurant sales are going up, because what is happening there, of course, is that you are getting a percentage of the franchise sales without the cost involved, more than likely, to build the restaurant, supply the restaurant, pay the restaurant's bills, all of the above. You know, the bottom line is that when you have a franchise restaurant that is set up correctly, you are basically getting huge amount of revenue coming right off the top. And just to give you an idea, I just brought up McDonald's, right? So company owned and operated, out of the $22 billion they take, is $12.7 billion. That also, over a 3-year basis, is declining by 11%. The franchise and affiliated revenue model inside McDonald's is $10.1 billion. That is growing by just about 3%. So you can see these restaurants in general, that's what it looks like they're basically doing. And it is pretty, you know what? It's the same number, too. This is cool, man. So McDonald's plans on taking in less money in 2019 also, yet their earnings per share is going up. McDonald's this year, $21 billion. They plan on making $7.64. Next year, $20.9 billion, just slightly less, but guess what? Earnings per share, $8.22. So bottom line is that it's like a royalty company taking it off the top. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks, and we go over to Booking Holdings. Now, Booking Holdings, folks, that's the price line. The low for the year is $1,630. The high is $2,228. Now, what was supposed to happen, folks, is that Priceline was supposed to come out with their numbers today. Bottom line is that they pushed it off till tomorrow. That is going to be coming out at the 4 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. What's going to be intriguing here is the number one, trying to figure out, okay, why did they push it off? Let's see if they say anything. Booking Holdings said it's confirming certain business. Oh, there it is. Okay, so they said it's confirming certain business metrics that also they report on a quarterly basis. It says that this is a statement they put out. Their financial results are finalized and ready to report. Their second quarter business metrics will be available tomorrow at 7:30 a.m. Bottom line is that this little baby, let's take a look at it. So you came down today, you came down with volume. You get a gap that's wide open at $1,919. That's going to get filled. And that's where the strength is, too. That's where it popped topside. You know, so we'll see where this shakes out. Bottom line, looks to me that when you just put this looking on a daily, that gap is a wide open gap that wants to get filled. In fact, there's two windows on that. The first window was on the way down. That was in November of 2017. Then you had to pop on the February of 2019. We get over that. So let's go take a look at the oil market for a second. So this is what you had happen out here this morning. You had, let's get the oil market up first. So we have crude oil up. Inside the crude oil market, if we take a look at this intraday, what you're going to see is that you start going downtown at 6 o'clock this morning. This was all about China came back. Bottom line, we're putting tariffs on them, taxes on them. Taxes we're going to pay. The tariffs on the goods that are coming into the country. But guess what? We're the ones that pay it. Bottom line, oil goes from a price point of $69.31. We get down to $66.32. Now, so China turned around. Bottom line said, okay, we're going to basically put the same amount of tariffs on your products that come into our country, meaning the dollar amount, okay? So that's what we're doing. Now, check it out, though. What's intriguing here is a couple of different things that are intriguing. Number one, that they basically picked the oil market. That's telling me that they have plenty of oil. And, you know, if you've been listening to our man, Mr. Jason Path, he kicks us off every trading day right now at 8:30 in the morning. Great show if you haven't heard it yet, folks. Check it out. You know, because we were talking about this, Tommy and I, on our show. We're talking about it with him. What's so intriguing here is that the storage in oil is huge right now, okay? Jason's a real data person, really sweet, big numbers, good numbers. So that's one aspect of, you know, oil pulling back, okay? Driving Stevens almost over, bottom line, oil pulling back. Second part of that, though, is that when China came out and said, okay, we're going to put 25% on, the first thing I heard of, even before I knew what they were going to, what type of products they were going to do, like, it's like, that's pretty cool, man. That's pretty wild. That means they have plenty of oil. Now, here's the products, okay? And this is where what you're going to start seeing happening now is this. And then whatever is in your portfolio, if you have a longer-term portfolio, you want to start looking at where you're sitting here. And this is why. There's going to be companies that no doubt get hurt big time, you know, because the bottom line is that the higher prices go, the less we all buy. Now, here's the products that they put the tariff on. And this goes on as of the 23rd of August. Fuel oil, diesel, lubricating oil, heavy oil and heavy oil products. Now, most times heavy oil products, folks, are used in the manufacturing business. That's how that shakes out. Petroleum and oil extracted from bituminous minerals and other oils, liquefied propane. The liquefied propane market, that's a big number. That, you know, we'll start pull up some LNG. Let's just pull up LNG right now. I don't believe the stock get that hit today, but guess what? It'll be a start. Yeah, Cheniere Energy. Okay, so Cheniere Energy today was down $1.32, $60.40. We pull this back. This has been a large consolidation. In 2016, it was down to $22. You're at $60 right now. Not a bad number. That's the bottom line. But, you know, this will end up, let me see if they break out China in here. No, this is just pipelines and maybe they don't even export. Let me just see. One second. Hold on. Okay. Focus on LNG-related business. The company owns a liquefied natural gas terminals, liquefied natural gas pipelines. Yeah, it doesn't look to me that they have... The ones that get hit are going to be the ones that actually... Well, listen, it still got hit, you know, because what we're going to see is that you're going to see that there's going to be less product needed. Because guess what? 25% tariff, are they going to pay it or not? I doubt it. Okay, so we're at liquefied propane. You got liquefied propane. We get asphalt, petroleum asphalt, motor gasoline and aviation gasoline. Oh, that's a big hit. Aviation kerosene and then other light oil distillate products. Bottom line, what you have there, it's a total match, dollar for dollar, for what we put on them. You know, so as this trade war, folks, is heating up, you want to wrap your head around it, because the bottom line is that we started off with $50 billion. You start getting up to $200 billion. If you go to $500 billion, guess what? At $500 billion, folks, that's going to be a taft on each and everything that comes in from China. On the other side of that, guess what? They will basically go on tit for tat on each one of those. That's just how it's going to shake out. That's what it looks to me. We go take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here today. And booking.com, folks, is going to come out with their numbers tomorrow after the close. That's how that's shaken out. We had Tesla was down 9.23. Bottom line, SEC, that's going to be the news in Tesla now. They're going to be all over him. And I have a hard time believing, folks, that he had the $50 billion lined up to do this deal. It's $50 billion would end up being, I believe, one of the biggest deal structures done from taking a company public to taking a private. And there's been some monster deals done. You know, most times, if that's the case, we would hear from other bankers, analysts, someone would know that, okay, a big deal is coming down, and we'd hear about it, particularly after the deal is out, and the deal's out right now. 877-927-6648. We'll see overnight. Stay right there. We've got another 10 minutes coming back. But the bottom line, overnight, we'll see whether the dollar continues lower. It looks to me like the dollar does want to continue lower. The big number tonight is going to be the yen. The yen, it looks to me like it's going to be getting stronger out here tonight. Right now, we're trading at 110.99. Coming right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. With over $56 million in cash and over $66 million in working capital, Great Panther Silver is positioned as a company with a solid foundation and poised for growth. While completely unhedged to the price of silver, Great Panther retains 100% ownership in 2 producing mines in Mexico, which is the top silver producing country in the world, along with future potential production in Peru. Great Panther is highly leveraged to the price of silver, and after a great year of performance in 2016, Great Panther Silver has a strong outlook for 2017 as well. With good liquidity in trading and strong fundamentals on the balance sheet, while remaining completely unhedged to the price
price of gold and silver, now is a perfect time to take a closer look at this equity. If you'd like to find out more about Great Panther Silver, then go to greatpanther.com or check them out on the NYSE Market, symbol GPL, or the TSX, symbol GPR.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow finished down 45, NASDAQ up 4, S&P's down 6. We go over and take a look at that yen, folks. What you have out here is the yen, the Japanese yen is this. We traded down today from 111.38 111.44 down at the 110.95 level. Now, your lowest swing point, we're already inside the lower range. Inside, when we got inside there today, 111.40 is the number. So we get inside there. Bottom line, it does two different things. It sets up a run to 110.59, and you very well might have a small ABC structure on the way down here. And a small ABC would take it down into the next 109 area. What's going to be intriguing, of course, is that what that will do inside the metal market, because what does happen is that when the yen gets strong, the gold contract is just the opposite correlation of that, meaning, it's the same correlation, meaning the yen gets strong, gold gets strong. That's how that works. The Japanese, of course, central bank can't stand it when the yen gets so strong, because that does damage inside the Nikkei. What tends to happen is that their central bank does let this thing go between the price point of $1.04 yen to one U.S. dollar to $1.13. If we bring this back, what you're going to see, we've been in this range for quite some time, you know. So it's range bound, and maybe they're just saying, okay, man, we're going to let it basically get down there again, because what we have, if you look at the yen, if you look at the dollar, if you look at the euro, they have all been range bound for a long period of time. The dollar has been trying to take out the 95. We take a look at the euro. The euro is, I believe, at 116. Yeah. The top of that range is laying out there at 118. We just went over the yen. So I expect you're going to see some decent currency action out here tonight. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows, and whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. We look forward to talking to you right here. Jason's on, 8:30 in the morning. Come join him. Meow! Go get him, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.